opportunity to really have something that's going to be here, not just another 20 years, but another 50 years.
Well, this is all that's left of the old Island Cow restaurant on Sanibel. Almost a year after fire tore through the popular restaurant, then Hurricane Ian threw another wrench in plans to rebuild.
NBC2's Claire Lavazorio is talking to the owner about the big plans to finally rebuild.
The lot where the Island Cow once stood has been cleared, but the memories of the restaurant are still here. Take a look. This yellow entrance sign is still on the lot from after the fire. The restaurant that's been through twice as much tragedy as the rest of the island is sharing their story of triumph. It was just after 11 o'clock on Saturday, August 6th. Several of Brian Podlasek's Island Cow employees had just clocked out for the night when he got a call.
When the phone rings and you're like, okay, this can't be good. Something's wrong.
Brian's gut was right, and a massive fire was tearing through his restaurant that's become a staple on Sanibel Island.
Life-changing.
Longtime general manager Amy Mancini says it's still hard to reflect on that night.
My father done most of the paintings inside, meeting my husband. At the restaurant, and to watch it all go up in flames was something. It's very hard to explain. It was one of the toughest days of my life.
For a while, Island Cow was the only tragedy on the island. Now, after Ian, many have joined their table. But over the next year, the new Island Cow will take shape.
Had there not been a hurricane, we'd have this thing not. You'd be having breakfast right now in a Bloody Mary, you know, and a big old breakfast burrito.
With the help of Stevens Construction, the Podlasek's are designing their new restaurant. It's 20% larger with a much bigger tiki bar out back.
I think those that have been coming to Island Cow for years and years and years are going to walk on the property and say, wow, this is Island Cow 2.0.
They'll still have the staples like bags, Adirondack chairs, and their famous muffins. The plan is to break ground on the restaurant in late summer and open doors once again, this time next year.
It's going to be a great opportunity to really have something that's going to be here, not just another 20 years, but another 50 years.
Local on Sanibel Island, Claire Lavazorio, NBC2.